and Stone Cold Steve Austin, wasting no time, going for the ribs of Jake the Snake Roberts. This is the final, ladies and gentlemen. The winner of this match will be the Camel Clutch, Lachlan. Good grief, folks. This is agony.
Now with complete control,
he's got the sleeper hold locked in. Can his opponent ride it out? He fights out. That'll knock you silly.
He just reversed that with ease.
That was a ton of velocity.
He strikes will make his opponent's arms heavy as heck.
The toll from this match is really starting to show. He got him. Steve Austin making his statement as we speak.
This is a painful submission hold and used to great effect here.
This is not the position you want to be in.
Just making his presence felt there.
Oh, a serious knockout blow.
We simply got to applaud the courage of both these warriors, folks.
Yeah, both of these warriors, as you call them, JR, were taken to the hospital earlier today, and now both are back battling here tonight.
He's looking for the win, and he's got some fight left in him.
You know, it's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in his tank.
Can he do it here? Dishing out some serious punishment here.
Well, it could be a changing of the guard here tonight.
The old man and the rattlesnake, huh, partner?
Oh, this isn't good.
Incredible move by Steve Austin. The King of the Ring Finals continues here. Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Stunner! Stunner!
With a stunner on Jake the Snake Roberts. And the referee counts as 3. And Austin has beaten Jake the Snake Roberts.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this bout. And now reigning King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And there you see Stone Cold Steve Austin.
The new King of the Ring for 1990s.
Austin 316 says, I just whipped your ass. As the King of the Ring, I'm serving notice to every one of the superstars. They're all on the list, and I'm fixing to start running through all of them. Steve Austin's time has come, and that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Oh, wait a minute, look at that.
His opponent from Calgary,
well, this should be quite the contest, Jerry. Stone Cold Steve Austin, Bret the Hitman Hart, finally going to meet one-on-one.
What if Stone... Cold Steve Austin used the sharpshooter to make Bret Hart submit. Ow! Here's the cover.
This one's not over yet.
Oh! And folks, it don't get more painful than that.
Talk about putting a target on someone's back.
You don't want to get caught outside the ring for too long. And he goes down hard.
Camel clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower back. And doing a great job of turning that around. Oh, that one hit the mark. You know, doing some checking, neither of these two men have ever submitted in a match in their entire career, JR.
Both men with strong wills, King, proud hearts, neither willing to give an inch.
Well, I believe it's going to come down to a submission in this matchup, which would obviously be a first. And how humiliating it would be for one of these guys to give up right here in New York City.
How ironic would it be if Stone Cold Steve Austin placed the sharpshooter on Bret Hart and won by submission?
Two.
He's targeting the midsection quite well at this point in time.
The reversal from Bret Hart.
That's some cruel and unusual damage being perpetrated.
Six.
You have to wonder, as this match wears on, whether or not the effects of those devastating holds and blows of Steve Austin will take their effect on Bret Hart, considering the Hitman was off for 6 months.
And for some reason, it's been an obsession with Austin and Bret Hart.
And there's the infamous camel clutch, putting so much pressure on the lower back.
Oh, that'll knock the wind out of you.
Oh, and folks, it don't get more painful than that. Easily avoided. Bam!
Oh, talk about getting flattened.
He hits the canvas.
Steve Austin being pressed hard. Will we see the Stone Cold Stunner? Will that be the move?
Bret Hart looking to end this quickly.
He's simply reminding him that he's there.
Hart hits the mat.
Hoping to get out of here early with a win.
Bam! When he gets going like this, there are a few better. Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects. Bret Hart, you gotta know, his body is ravaged with pain right now.
Could you imagine what it could mean, or what it would mean, for Steve Austin's career if he could say, I mean, make Bret Hart quit in New York's most historic arena, Madison Square Garden. And that's what he's trying to do right now.
Oh, and folks, it don't get more painful than that. The counter.
Oh, wait. Nice reversal.
Sharpshooter. Hart's got the sharpshooter locked in. A perfectly executed sharpshooter. Simply scintillating. He's got him down. Is this it? Calgary's own Bret Hart looks to be in great shape. He had a personal trainer to help him. The Campbell clutch being applied. Steve Austin now being set up by the Hitman.
Well, Bret Hart is battled, and he's been pummeled. But now Bret Hart is on the offense.
Time will tell if the Hitman has
the shoulders are down.
I'd say that's more embarrassing than anything else.
Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight.
Here. Look at this.
Yeah, Bret Hart, he won't quit. He doesn't know how to quit.
And again. Bret Hart being over.
And there's the sleeper. This could be lights out.
Things are certainly going his way. A good escape. He reversed it. Nobody's going to recognize him after that. And there's the reversal from Bret Hart.
Oh, that'll leave a mark. Well, Bret Hart has done it all here in the heart of New York, except for beating Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah, he won the title right here at WrestleMania 10 in the Garden. And there's the counter. He's looking for the win. Now, every move is designed to get the fans off their feet.
He's in big trouble.
Bam!
He's looking at it. Austin! No!
Oh, my. Steve Austin. It could be over here.
Has finally conditioned a competitor as we have in our game. But he's hurting right now, JR.
I think Austin's surprised that Bret Hart has been able to withstand the punishment the Rattlesnake has dished out, and it's tired him.
Well, I'll tell you this, Austin better get untired in a hurry if he wants to win this match. He's showing no signs of letting up.
A spectacular counter by Steve Austin. He's inflicting some serious pain here. Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
When you're beat up, the last thing you...
My God Almighty, going for the cover!
Two.
Of execution here.
Three.
Look out. He's got his sights set on the neck region.
Camel clutch locked in. Wrenching on the neck and lower back. Really going to work here. Just wrenching that thing.
Steve Austin with the offense.
He's going for the three count.
One, two, three.
That's a Hitman Hart. Battled valiantly, but just ran out of gas.
Ladies and gentlemen,
well, I hate to bring this up, King, but Bret Hart took a little turn on you when he knocked you on your keister.
Yeah, and I didn't appreciate it one bit. Let me tell you, I think Bret Hart was out of line for doing that, as well as being out of line for the abusive obscenities that he heard on live television. There's absolutely no excuse for that, no matter how much this man, so-called, has been screwed.
Well, well, you almost called him a son of a...
No, I didn't.
Well, look out. Here we go.
Doing a number now.
I'm not so certain that this match we called right down the middle by our guest here.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Wow, Austin's just opening a can.
Oh my gosh, big time impact. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades. And all of it can be used to cause massive damage. It'll take a minor miracle to come back from this.
And Steve Austin is doing an excellent job dominating this match.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't imagine that this will be business as usual. This is a painful submission hold and used to great effect here. There's the escape. It's really hard to imagine what's going through the head of Randy's out. He gets out. Great offense by Steve Austin.
Well, we're on the move here.
This is a painful submission hold and used to great effect here. Remember, our guest here is only here to officiate the match, not get involved. Of course, I'll believe that when I see it. And there's the reversal from Bret Hart. Oh, what impact.
Oh, out of nowhere.
be honest with you, I don't imagine that this will be business as usual.
End of story. This one's over.
Steve Austin with the offense.
Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects. The crab is cinched in. The knee is torqued, putting the back in a lot of trouble. Great hold being applied.
It's really hard to imagine what's going through the head of our guest here. They may be having a hard time staying out of this matchup. Sometimes all it takes is a basic strike.
Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt. He's got him hooked.
And now Bret Hart pushing forward.
Well, we're on the move here. Austin's in a fighting mood.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now. And down goes Austin. This is a painful submission hold and used to great effect here. Well, to be honest with you, I don't imagine that this will be business as usual.
Well, thanks for coming. He's in full-on attack mode now. He's just lethal with that thing. This might not end well.
Oh, my. Steve Austin.
He's applying pressure in all the right places. This one could be over.
Whoa! Don't get up!
Oh, you better be careful, Stone Cold. Oh!
Austin,
if he knocks Bret out, Bret can't say I quit.
This I Quit match, Ken Shamrock the referee. We are in Chicago. This is WrestleMania 13. Neither Austin or the Hitman have ever submitted in their professional careers. It's all on the line here. A lot of pride. Who's the alpha male? Nice leg sweep by the Hitman.
Man, this crowd is going wild, JR. They're waiting to hear one of these superstars say they quit.
And you got to think that the Hitman is second sharpshooter, focusing on the leg of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Uh-oh, this is not going to be good for the Rattlesnake. Oh, man.
Bret Hart.
Oh, man, look at this. Ow!
The figure four using that ring post as leverage. Shamrock trying to free Stone Cold. And Austin, damage has been done. Austin in a bad, bad way.
But he still will not say he quits.
The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
A spectacular counter by Steve Austin. And there's the reversal from Bret Hart.
He's in big trouble.
Can you believe the strain on that arm at this point in the match? Boy, oh boy.
And he's out. That was a ton of velocity.
Oh, look at this, JR. Man, I'm telling you, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Oh, look out!
Inverted atomic drop. And Austin, that's a low blow, technically. Again, a no disqualification match. Referee Ken Shamrock helpless to do anything about it. Now what's the Hitman doing?
Look out.
Steel chair. Bret Hart bringing a steel chair in the ring. It's as legal as a wrist lock.
Things are about to get ugly.
Oh! Back to the leg. Austin in trouble.
Oh, no.
Hart's got evil intentions.
This is going to be damn bad, JR. This is going to be real bad. Look at this. This is going to be... Wait a minute. Bret Hart took too long. Stone Cold got the chair.
Oh, man. The steel chair right in the spine. From downtown Victoria, Texas.
Oh, look at Austin. He is begging Bret Hart to get back to his feet. And that... Look out, JR. Austin's got the chair.
Austin keeping his word. He said he was going to... beat the hell out of Hart, and he's doing it with that steel chair. Nothing the referee can do about it. The stakes are high.
It's Pebble Clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower back.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't imagine that this will be business as usual. It's really hard to imagine what's going through the head of our guest here. They may be having a hard time staying out of this matchup. Well, to be honest with you, and there's the infamous camel clutch, putting so much pressure on the lower back. And there's the reversal from Bret Hart.
Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
And he brings the action back inside the ring. And he's headed back in, going to the well again. Remember, our guest here is only here to officiate the match, not get involved. Of course,
well, that's it.
I'm not so certain that this match we called right down the middle by our guest here.
Submission hold applied, and the rest in position.
There's no escaping this.
It's really hard to imagine what's going through the head of our guest here. They may be having a hard time staying.
In the wake of WrestleMania 13, as audiences began to gravitate towards Stone Cold Steve Austin, a dark cloud began to form, separating the Hitman from fans south of the Canadian border.
First of all, I want to apologize.
What?
To all my great fans in Canada.
For what?
And to you, my fans right here across the United States of America, I apologize for nothing. You take a gunless creep like Stone Cold Steve Austin and beat him to a bloody pulp, even though you all know that he lost, you cheer him on the way back to the dressing room like he won.